Well, I got the old rock and roll convertible pulled in here to get ready for the engine swap. And the main reason that I'm going to have to go ahead and start pulling the old engine before the new one's finished is because I'm missing some of these brackets and what have you to go with the accessories. And I won't be able to get the new engine done until I get this one out. So that's the reason for it. I'm not worried about the engine job. That's something I know I can do, but the rest of the restoration on this car is going to be a very big job. But a long-term project, you know, once it's mobile, safely drivable with a good powertrain, then we'll have a lot more freedom to work on it at leisure. Hopefully this pulling in the shop was the last time it'll have to run off of my underhood fuel cell, because the gas tank's rusted out and I have all that new. Get ready to tear it down. Well, everything is pretty well disconnected. All the radiators out, all the hoses disconnected, power steering lines, transmission, the wiring harness, and everything's bundled up on top. Even got the motor mount nuts off. But what I can't get off is the exhaust. The nuts on these studs down here. See that stud in the center of the screen? And there's another one on the other side, barely visible. Well, those aren't coming out. And this thing's been in Florida and probably driven on the beach. And so there's some rust under there on that. And in order to get that out, I'm gonna have to get destructive with the plasma torch. And got the garden hose over there in case I start a fire. And I'll try to get that torch down in there and destroy those studs and get them out of the way. Now, they're gonna have to forgive the bad camera angle, because I don't want the camera too close or else I'll get spark burns in the lens. And I don't feel like ruining my camera. Not a lot of room to work. Try a different position. One bolt gone. And that's the other. Sometimes it's fun to use destructive tools, you know. Well, there it is, sitting on the ground or on a cart. Doesn't look too good, but I knew it didn't look good. Got some botulism showing right there. Been botched by previous repairs. A little bit of oil leaking going on back here, it looks like. Looks like that something plastic melted and burned right there. So, a little bit of oil in the exhaust, which, considering the condition of the engine, that's to be expected. 125C. That's the oil pump plate that I need down there that puts the filter here instead of the new engine where it sticks out. And then we have the vacancy. I left the axles in so that I can sit it back down on the ground and push it outside to wash in here, because I've got a new steering gear coming. And you see that's dented in, and I know that'll reduce the air conditioner a good bit, so I want to get that fixed, clean that out in there. So yeah, that's my stopping point for today. Engine on the ground, that's what I wanted.